Oh, hey, what's up, YouTube? My name is Brandon Desjolais, and I'm here with Stoked Ride Shop to bring you the 5 easiest beginner longboarding tricks. Let's hit it. First trick we're gonna be learning today is the body varial. Step number one of the body varial, standing in a wide position. Step number two is gonna be getting your knees loosened up, ready to jump. Step number three is gonna be jumping over. Make sure you lead with the back arm here, your back shoulders. Step number four is gonna be dropping into position. A couple things are gonna help on this one. Make sure that when you jump really centered and you're not really leaping. Another thing is try and jump and land with your back foot first and then your front foot. This is gonna make sure the weight ends on that front foot. Second trick we're gonna be learning today is the nollie pivot. Step number one of the nollie pivot is making sure you're getting your front foot on the nose, back foot in the middle of the board. Step number two is gonna be bringing your shoulders and your upper body back and kind of winding up. Step number three is gonna be pulling those shoulders and those arms over, twisting at your hips, and really twisting your upper body 180 as you put weight into the nose. Step number four is gonna be sticking it. A couple things that are gonna help with this is actually if you ride a little bit more on the truck, it's gonna make it consistent because then you can put much more weight on your front foot without the board picking up. A common problem people have is they'll throw their shoulders to here and try and poke the legs out. The problem with that is that your shoulders are then gonna be holding you back, and you really wanna make sure with this move, your shoulders are pulling you through the move. Trick number three today is gonna be the ghost ride. Step number one of the ghost ride is gonna be bringing that front foot back to the middle of the board. Step number two is gonna be taking that back foot off the heel side edge over your front foot. Step number three is gonna be taking a step with your front foot, and step number four is gonna be jumping back on your board. A couple things that could help out here, make sure that as you step over with your back foot, you're really leaping forward and taking the weight off the board. The common problem that people have is that as they do this, they really push off and their board doesn't keep riding with them. With the ghost ride, you can also do this by taking just your front foot off first. The problem with doing it this way is that it tends to put more weight on your back foot and can be a little bit more dangerous. Trick number four today is gonna be the nollie shove it. Step number one is gonna be the same thing, step on the nose. Step number two is gonna be winding up. Step number three, again, is gonna be throwing those shoulders over, getting the momentum going, putting weight on the front foot. The only difference is, right when you get to about 90, you're gonna let go of the board, and step number four is gonna be, bam, planting in and landing in your normal riding position. A couple things that are gonna help with this is really try and focus on making sure, as you learn the nollie pivot, that you're doing it more as a sliding pivot instead of putting all the weight onto the nose and slapping it down. The reason here is because with the nollie shove it is you're basically starting the motion and you have to let go of it and let it go around the whole way. So to do the nollie shove it, you should have your nollie pivot pretty much on lock. The fifth and final trick we're gonna be learning today is the ghost ride kickflip. Step number one, same thing, gonna be bringing that front foot back to the middle of the board. Step number two is gonna be taking those two steps off the board. Step number three, that as you jump on the board, you kind of scoop the bottom with your toe, flick the board. Step number four is gonna be catching it and landing back in your normal position. A couple things that help with this is really make sure that back foot is super stiff and your toes are curled up. And you wanna make sure that while you're doing the flip, you're not just kicking the board out in front of you, but you're really picking your knee straight up and making sure the board flips right under you. All right, YouTube, so that concludes the 5 easiest beginner longboard tricks that you can learn. My name is Brandon, I'm here with Stoked Ride Shop. Today, I'm riding the Moonshine Eclipse Firm Flex Paris V3 Trucks 180mm 50° and the Pal Peralta Snakes in 66mm. If you guys have any questions, drop them below or shoot us a line info@stokedrideshep.com. Anyways, skate safe and stay stoked.